That's one tree.
gonna be the backup.
I hope not.
We won't be able to see the paint. There's that little scouter plane.
On the other side over there. You see it?
Wow.
Oh, we just dropped it.
Is that all he has?
Mm-hmm.
So he'll have to go back for more.
And it's so big, I mean, it's moving too fast to be a blimp, but I can't really tell what he looks like. He just looks like a blimp. Looks like he's blimp.
He's making it pretty obvious that's what he's trying to do for the TV man.
Frog hunting up the middle for him.
Monty, you look really cute.
You held good.
We got the evidence on you, Tony.
You're on movie camera. The whole thing.
I don't think there's much we can do with a shovel.
Mm-hmm.
Gonna see if he can get in front of it.
Don't hit some fucking woods, man.
I know. He's doing it. Everyone's gonna say, "What the hell were you doing while the fire was burning?" We're sitting up here taking pictures. Yeah,
Donnie's got the big water truck.
4.5 hours, a lot of smoke and sweat later. This is what we ended up with. Out there in the distance on that hillside's where Doug made his fire trail. Barely visible right in the center now. Going crossways. The only place that didn't burn. Still pretty hot down there on the end. We're not down there. Fire swept to our right as you're viewing this. All the way through this whole area. Kind of made it desolate. Got into the trees down there. Fortunately, never crowned out. We got it stopped down in there. Big one over the hill, and it looks bad. Then coming across, we had three more that looked like they've been put out, except for that little one. We just hope it doesn't grow. beautiful atmosphere here. Must be a deck load, so we scaled the important one. BJ and Jake fell the furthest one. Jack fell this closest one. But I don't know who fell the middle one. No mark on it. Looks like a lot of defect on this one. Rot in there. And all manner of stuff that's not nice. But it should still scale good. And these are all little logs.
Well, this is up on the Skookum sail. This is fairly typical of too much of the wood we have. There's some pretty nice trees here, but a lot of little stuff. This scab patch right here in front of us is an example of what they're giving us for a landing. Good on chains. The blue marked trees here go, and the rest stay. And this road's a dividing line, and this over here is a leave tree marked unit. It really isn't too awful bad when you consider that the trees that don't have paint on, you get to cut, like those pine there. Again, a beautiful landing. Well, here we are at another landing. This one will be a little bit better. This is the general landing area. Ribbons going off into the distance there. Leave tree marked unit. Trees marked in red don't get cut. And what they do is they try to leave a few scattered around for later, I guess. Won't really look too bad once we take the bigger trees out of it. Open it up a bit.
we're going to do a little road building today. And this is looking down the proposed road right away. And as you can probably hear behind me, Doug is opening a way through. And we'll document a bit of road building today. These trees here will skid into the landing back there where my pickup is. And we've got a unit up here that Chris Dad sheared, and they're going to come up this weekend and skid it. And then we're going to pull the trees that are left. And we're putting in a road for both of our uses. This up here was a clear cut that Chris Dad sheared. And we came in and felled the trees that were left on it, which, as you can see from the tops out there, probably weren't very many. That's kind of the area there. The road will go down there to that leaning, light-colored tree and swing and cross the creek bottom down there. We'll walk on down and have a look at it. Okay, this is the approximate location of the crossing. This is the Deep Creek Sale, by the way. And Chris had sheared all those trees over there. You can see piles scattered around through there. And we're going to come in and log everything that's left. So when we're done, this will be a clear cut. The landing will be right over there on that little hump, just slightly higher than our location here. And we'll just kind of come down the hill, down to the bottom, down right in there, cross, and come right back up through here. The road will go right out the edge of the clear cut, end up out there where Doug's working, and where my pickup is. This will be our road right away, right up through here, those ribbons. Well, winter is here. Most beautiful time of the year. This is going to be a clear cut. 9-inch DBH. Also, virtually all these trees here. A mushroom cloud in reverse. Virtually all these trees here will hit the ground. Now let's walk up and take a quick look at it. Well, we've got several guys working here today. The landing wasn't busy, so we put Buck on it. He's over there somewhere. Old Joe, he's still at her. Tough as always. Over here we got Jack. See if he can get that tree to go where he wants it. Thank you. knock a limb off. Now this one here is a widowmaker. He knows that we talked about it. You can see a tree leaning into it there from the back. And it's a dead one. That's the top of it right up there. It goes down. Got a big old rotten face in it. So Jackson's gonna want to be very careful here. Taking a shallow face cut out. Looking over good. Looking for his escape route there. Getting his partner's attention. Doing the right thing. Okay. Well, he's gonna make this whole mess fall, hopefully. He's really in a pretty safe place because there's no underbrush. It does have a spiked dead top in it. It can break out as it falls. Go. One undoubtedly tore a lot of wood. So he's bucking it off there to get rid of the torn wood. He didn't dare cut it all the way off. He'd have had to stay there too long. Looks like Joe's gonna pick on that little tamarack right there in the center. No, looks like maybe he's not. Shovels yet, for which we're very glad. I know I'm wiggling here a little bit. I'm balancing on a snow-covered log turned sideways, so forgive the wiggle. Love those tamaracks. Uh-huh. Jack's gonna make another snowstorm. Snow for a week or so, but it certainly hasn't gotten bad yet, for which we're really glad. It's gonna come. Buck might even fall a tree here in a minute.
Buck. This is what happens when loggers come into the woods and runs the deer out. There's a log right there that was just fell. Tops. And of course what they're in here for is to eat the moss out of the tops. Pull forward just a little bit here. I'll bet he hasn't even run off. Isn't that something?